can never really find a good sound effect of a guy getting hit in the head with a shovel.
Good evening, sir. May I interest you in our soup de jour?
Shut the fuck up, you goddamn fuckhole! You piece of shit! The Opie and Anthony
Show. Let's get Erica in here. She's from Rhode Island, right? Actually, was she the one that was hungover and couldn't come last week?
Yeah.
Are we on the air? Because it says, what the F, what's up with the technical difficulties music coming up? It happened yesterday at noon.
No, we're on.
Nice dead air, jackass, dead air. Oh, okay.
We're on. It's on the.
I guess there was some dead air.
Yesterday.
No, right now.
We're reading it now.
Dead air, dead air, dead air. We just missed most of what you said coming in from break.
You heard nothing?
Okay, it's fixed now.
It's fixed now?
Oh, great. They missed us reading more instant feedback.
We missed all that.
You missed all that? That was really funny. We were just getting killed on the instant feedback because of that author of the book Falling Stars, Anthony. That's what we were talking about and laughing really hard at.
A couple of people enjoying the dead air more than the author, Opie, on instant feedback.
Why couldn't they have the dead air in the middle of that other segment? So they didn't hear any of these? Oh, there were some funny ones,
the
too,
last,
man.
Like, five that we did.
They were good ones.
They only heard the last five?
Oh, that's interesting.
All right, well,
did you guys just hear Jaime?
Yes, I did.
Okay, me too. Hi, Jaime.
I was being a professional, Jimmy, and just acknowledging that I heard it, but not acknowledging it on the air. Very good.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you heard it. I wanted to make sure.
Did everyone hear in your ear? It was in the left ear. I heard Jaime say, is this on?
You're right.
All right, we're good. We're good to go.
Major point.
Major point.
So they didn't hear the instant feedback coming out?
No, not that one.
Oh, that was some funny stuff.
They were good ones, too.
They could not hear it on the replay.
All right. Well, we got Erica in the studio.
Hello.
It's Couch Lady.
Hi. How are you?
Hello.
So what's the deal? You were supposed to be here last week with the couch?
Yes, and unfortunately, I had a little
incident?
Oh.
Infection?
No.
In what?
I don't know. I guess I had anxiety last week.
Oh, you had an anxiety attack?
I had an anxiety attack.
Is that why our porn stars had to have lesbian sex on a piece of fiberglass?
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
That's all right.
So I was going to wake up really early in the morning and try
to... Wait, are you the same girl that was just sitting out there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why? I was just wondering.
Because there's other girls that have been walking through. Yeah. I guess he was a little confused.
There's another girl sitting next to me that's blonde.
Oh, well, I told you there's a bunch of people out there now.
Oh. I get you. Yeah.
What's your name?
Erica.
Erica. So you own a furniture store?
Well, we had an antique consignment shop for home furnishings, and we have a bunch of stuff that
But you're
we
the same
had.
Girl sitting right there.
Yeah,
like, yeah I told you.
Huh.
Right. Are you married?
No.
Oh, nice. I don't know.
Getting married.
Oh, not nice.
Could you tell us more about the furniture store?
It's closed.
I thought it would make a good
It's closed because you oversleep?
Book guy we just listened to.
No, it's...
Why did it close down?
Economy's not good.
No. And you
Pretty
oversleep
much
a lot?
I'm a crapper, so...
Yeah.
And I what?
And you oversleep a lot.
Well,
I heard you had a problem last week.
Gave me something for anxiety.
Hey, come get back on mic.
Knocked me out cold, and I just did not wake up.
Really?
Wait, who gave you this medicine?
My doctor.
Right. And so you had some anxiety and he gave you something to make you sleep?
Yeah, he goes, here, take one of these. I'm like,
what were you anxious about?
Just
things.
Whatever. And I took one and knocked me out cold for like 12 hours straight. And I apologize.
Same girl, huh?
It worked. You weren't anxious for 12 hours.
Yeah, exactly.
There's something about this glass.
Kind of works,
is what I'm thinking.
Oh, the couch.
Oh, here comes the lesbian couch that Erica brought in. We're having a ceremony. Do we have any, music that we could play? We should have thought ahead of time.
Lesbian couch music, Opie?
Little Katie Lang.
What do you want, a polka?
I think there's like a heart filter on that glass or something.
I'm gonna
wipe. A what?
Like, in the heart videos. Oh. All right, where's the couch?
Very nice.
Jim's on the lesbian couch.
You bet I am.
You want to explain what the lesbian couch is for the people at home? You're the expert on couches.
It's just a love seat, probably from the 80s.
Yes, it is. A love seat.
From the late 80s.
Late 80s?
Probably late 80s.
Only the best for your pals, Opie and Anthony.
Early, I don't know exactly what year.
Any stains on it?
No, it's clean.
Where was it all this time?
Yeah, where was it for 20 years?
Come on, tell
the
truth.
If it doesn't sell in the store after so long, we take ownership of it, and it's out in the warehouse for a little while.
It goes to the warehouse for half price.
Oh, we got...
If it doesn't sell...
We got the black light. We're going to make sure this is a...
Need an extension cord, guys. I don't think it's
going to not as good as through the mirror, Opie? Is that what you're trying to say?
No, I didn't say that, really.
You can say it.
There was, I don't know. Like, you just looked different when you were sitting out there. That's all.
are you saying?
She's lovely. Stop.
I know she's lovely.
Stop trying to cause trouble. Norton's causing trouble.
I'm not at all. I'm trying to sit on the couch and look at her hiney.
You have a nice hiney. She goes, oh.
Do you have an extension cord?
Black light?
Yeah, we're going to check it with the black light.
All right, we're plugging in the black light.
Want to see if anybody's been having any hanky-panky.
I have no idea.
It's nice to find a homicide committed on this couch at 86.
Could only dream.
Turn off the lights.
Ooh.
This will
definitely make this more gooder.
She's light out.
We have to get some curtains, by the way, for them stupid.
We do help the black light.
Matt, curtains for you, see?
I asked you guys what you wanted. I could have brought curtains.
The couch is fine.
Yeah, the couch is fine.
A post-1981 couch?
I have no idea what year it's from.
It does look kind of 80s.
All right, let's turn on the black light. Here we go.
Yeah, but you know what? It's kind of, you're not going to.
It's fine. It'll serve the purpose.
Yeah, for a bunch of dykes.
Don't black light the girl. Black light the couch.
Oh, boy. Can you turn it on?
What are you doing?
Why doesn't anything work on this show, ever?
Danny, get that black light working. That's the important thing.
All right, now we're trying to figure out how to turn on the black light.
Right. Come over here. I'll fill out your card.
Wow, this show is just going downhill in a hurry.
No!
We can't figure out the black light.
It's fine.
Danny, what's wrong with the black light?
I don't know. It's not turning on.
Danny?
Sorry.
Calm down.
Danny?
It'll be okay.
Well, I tested it before I brought it in to make sure that it worked before I brought it here.
Perhaps For some reason, extension cord's bad.
Perhaps I'm laying in the booth.
Plug it directly into the wall and see if it works. Perhaps socket is bad.
There you go.
There's plenty of things that...
All right, we got the black light on.
It's the extension cord.
It's the extension cord. Everyone calm down.
All right, pull the couch over and give it a once-over.
How do you know if there's a load on there? What do you see?
You'll see white.
Oh, my God. Is that X-Files music? Very good.
All right, we're checking the lesbian couch for splooge marks. So far, so good, right?
Anything?
We're getting a thumbs up. Oh, they're pointing out something, Steve. Eric, Jim?
Yeah.
And on the armrest would be where you would bend a girl over and bang her.
All right, Steve.
Absolutely.
What are you seeing?
Big white stain
Let me see.
I'm not lying.
Take a look.
Uh-oh.
What does it look like, Mulder?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. You would absolutely use that part of the couch, too. You would bend her over that.
That's a definite load right there. A dried-up load.
That light detects semen.
Oh, there's another one. There's something going on over there. Where your upper back would rest on the back of the couch there, Anthony. All right. What is that? Is that urine? Oh, that's just the design. No, what is that? Is that the pattern of the couch?
Yeah. It is now.
All right. That's what... I don't know, man. Is that the pattern of the couch, or is this just splattered?
Splooge stain.
Splooge. Oh, what about that stain?
That's the pattern.
Oh, my God. Okay. All right, I see the pattern.
Yeah. The pattern is called jizz stain.
It was very popular in the early 80s.
Oh, there's another big stain right there?
What do you think? Wait a minute. Maybe that's just the pattern, too. I think we have a relatively clean lesbian couch.
I think so, too.
There's one or two spots on it, but...
Well, I don't know. Let's go back to the stain on the right armrest.
There's leaves in it?
There's leaves in the couch, Anthony. Yes.
I aired it out yesterday.
What?
I aired it out yesterday and the leaves...
Outside. Leaves fell?
Yeah. All right, she aired it out.
Thanks.
Wow, look at that. A condom. No.
All
right, I think we're pretty clean, no?
It's clean. For 1,000 young couches.
Let's go back to this stain over here. I think this might be just part of the pat. No, that's a stain. Okay.
Yeah,
we
that's
definitely
a stain.
Have one stain in.
All right, well, hopefully tomorrow we'll get a bunch more stains on that thing.
Okay.
Sorry, Jimmy, you won't be here. Remember? That was nice. I like that. The lights were out, the X-Files music playing,
yeah, like
the weird black light on, like they're investigating something. Very nice.
That was good. Well, guys, the show became more gooder today. We now have our lesbian couch back.
Yeah.
Too bad there's no lesbians here to use it.
I know.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow we're going to do
maybe
that.
They can't
the
make
dykes
it tomorrow.
Will come out tomorrow.
All right.
Well, I hope you appreciate it. And
very much.
Use it often.
So when are you getting married?
I was supposed to get married this month.
But what happened?
Why?
Uh-oh.
Because of the store closing and other stuff, so we decided to push it off to the summer.
Did he bring it up to you?
Oh, like, no, it had nothing to do with Ben.
No? No. He didn't bring it up to you and say, perhaps, you know, the store closing, we should push this off? Yeah, guys tend to really want to postpone those things.
Who's Ben?
So be it. My fiancé.
Oh, I'm thinking of Ben Sparks here.
Fiancé.
Our own producer. So maybe he whipped out that big, delicious treat.
It's not a big deal.
No?
No.
It's one of those take it or leave it, married or not married things?
Well, whatever. It will happen.
Isn't it kind of an important thing, though, in life?
It is, and
you should be kind of
planned.
Excited about that, no?
You know, yeah, you are, but, you know, you can't dwell on it if it happens. Mm. You know, you got to postpone.
If it happens, it happens.
If it happens, you know, it's
this is a story here. Yeah.
What's
yeah.
the story? Come on. How long you dated Share. Ben?
I have been dating Ben for a little over 3 years.
Okay.
Ooh.
His mom owns the store, you know.
The mom doesn't like you.
Oh, no. She's in New York.
Oh.
She's cool. It's just that the economy went down the shitter, and
no,
you know, people don't want to buy stuff that's
Listen to Bush,
used.
It didn't.
It's got leaves on it, yeah.
Yeah, they want to buy new stuff and not pay 2 years and no interest, you know, so they don't want to go spend their money.
Oh, it was used furniture.
Because it's consignment shop. Exactly. It's all used stuff.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
People
kind of want
saying?
New furniture.
So
yeah, they want their furniture
go
without
to
splooge
the big furniture
stains on it.
Right.
They want clean furniture.
They want to shop at Siemens, not have furniture with semen on it.
Right. God forbid they want clean stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Do you have sales on Tuesday? Starting at noon.
We're selling the best used furniture with the biggest splooge stains. This Tuesday night, come in. For our splooge stain spectacular at splooge stains. No, of course it's not named splooge stains. Your store wasn't named splooge stains, was it?
No. And so, I'm not going to say the name of the store.
Okay.
No.
So now things with Ben, you want to get married, but...
Oh, yeah, we're totally going to get married. We're now changing the entire concept of the wedding. We were going to do that typical, you know... Big reception and the everyone sits down for a dinner and the photographer and the limo, you know, that whole
tame it down.
The whole wedding now is going to be
just get a tent in the backyard.
No, that's what we're doing. We're going. Money was an issue. I'm not going to lie.
Okay,
money was a total issue. So
well, it sounds like it.
Just a tent with a bunch of load stained couches.
Instead of spending $30,000, we're going to cut it back probably to 10.
Fine.
So we'll just have a big fat party this summer and.
All right.
Sort of sounds like you're going through a tough time.
No, I mean, not necessarily.
No?
I'm getting through it. I'm fine.
Well, it sounds like with the anxiety and the furniture store closing and the marriage having to be postponed and scaled back.
I'm a mess, fine.
Yeah, it does sound like, you know, it's a little bit of stress in your life. And I'm glad you could take time out from your stressful life and
working.
Bring us a lesbian couch.
So I had all the time in the world.
There are other ways to earn money.
Jimmy will show you.
At the hotel I stayed at last night next door.
Oh, did you stay in the city?
I stayed next door at...
How do you get the couch here? In your car?
In a minivan.
In a minivan.
Which hotel did you stay at?
Ugh, the one to the...
Is it the
right.
one Opie used to stay at?
Similar.
Oh, yeah?
What's it called?
I don't know. You tell
the
us.
The one right here to the right of the building.
Oh,
how
the
could I
right.
think of it?
I didn't even know there was a hotel there.
The Salisbury Hotel.
That's awful?
Isn't that a homeless hotel?
I walked in going, ugh.
I think that's a flop house.
It's like a flop house or something.
I thought it was classy.
I don't know.
It's so not.
Le Parc Meridian is right across the street.
And
that's a wonderful hotel. I love it.
Why didn't you stay at the old Parc Meridian?
I didn't even know
because
it was there.
Because business is bad.
That's true.
No, not necessarily. I
couldn't
really
afford
care.
It, Jim, okay? Thanks for rubbing it in.
I
really,
wouldn't
Jim.
Stay there. For 4 hours, I mean, I got to bed at midnight.
She can't afford her wedding, and you spend $30,000 a year on hookers.
Why'd you get up in the morning?
Why'd you?
I didn't know what time necessarily you guys could take it in, so I just decided to
Were you trying to sleep after the anxiety medication and... Thinking about the business going down and sleeping in the hotel with the red neon light blinking through the window.
Actually, no, I fell right to sleep and then I got up and showered and came over here.
Really?
See you guys.
Wasn't cool. that big a deal?
No. I'm sorry. I got nothing. I'm a mess.
Trying to sleep and this is outside. What? What? I
just want to drop the couch off. Huh?
I know. I'm glad I brought it for you guys. No, you kidding.
No, we're happy. You
Have
kidding
some.
Me?
Oh, no, I'm glad.
That's better than the last one we had.
Yeah, it was a little road trip for me to take, you know?
Yeah, no, awesome. Good. We'll give you some prizes.
Yeah, I actually have prizes for you guys.
What do you have?
What do you have?
I brought some other stuff for you.
What? What gifts?
Would you like me to get it?
Sure would.
Yeah.
I am, follow, no, not donkey sausage kind
no, no,
of thing.
No, 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 follow Ben out the door.
Donkey
and get,
sausage.
And get the other stuff.
What kind of gifts?
I don't know.
Yeah.
It's just little.
All right,
stuff.
Yeah, go get the gifts.
Yeah. I'd like a gift.
Lock the door. Lock the door. Lock the door.
Opie, it's on outside.
Oh.
No, I want to...
Audio's on outside.
She's coming back in with her gifts. All right. Shut up, Ben. Jesus. Ben's giggling like a nut out there.
Bring her in.
Bring her in.
Oh, I didn't know what you were doing.
Bring the lady in with the gifts.
Jesus.
Bring in the present lady.
Right. Replay. Talk anything you want. Oh, about me. Right. I really don't care.
That's what sucks about this show.
They don't get, stupid replay.
Stupid replay.
Don't offend me. Save
no.
Me.
All right. We like you, actually.
Yeah.
What kind of gifts?
What do we got?
It's a magazine.
A sink magazine that
no,
we're in?
A wine gift.
That we have?
Huh?
You
want
to sign it?
You want us to sign
that's
stuff?
A gift.
And what's with the pink hat?
Pink hat? Is that a gift?
Is that yours?
Steve, we got a gift.
No, like I said, the store's closed, and, you know, I listen all the time, so, you know, I heard a couple different things, so
oh,
I went
boy.
Through the store and grabbed some stuff just for...
All righty.
You know, grab you guys.
All right, let's see what she's got for everybody.
Well, I have.
Well, considering
Buckle
Opie
in.
Has nothing to entertain with, I grabbed something.
Uh-oh.
Oh, it's not bad.
What is it? All is right. It one of those things that's used for jacking off, like in 10 to midnight?
No, it's just a simple little dish that he can just throw on the table. When
he oh, and like chips can go
oh,
in there?
Wow.
This is like a housewarming.
Hey, wow. You haven't got a housewarming
oh,
gift yet, have
boy.
You?
So you gave Opie something that
it's
is
gay.
Breakable.
I really, you know,
oh, Jesus Christ.
That's where we all get our gifts.
Why would you give Opie something that he could perhaps accidentally drop?
You
could
have washed it before you gave it to me. Jesus, there's leftover dip in the dip
check
part.
The price tag on the back.
She spent $13.50 on me. Thank you.
And then I got two beer pitchers for you guys in case.
Oh, we might need pitchers. That's
hey,
true.
I just grabbed some stuff.
Don't what? I don't understand. What? Don't be defensive. You're
yeah,
bringing us gifts, and we
gifts.
Appreciate them.
I'll just smash this.
No, he is the worst.
What?
You
say
are the
anything.
Worst. Right, wow, so, now that's a nice picture.
It is a nice picture.
Is it glass?
No, it's that hard plastic,
oh, it's,
right?
It's plastic.
Those are good to drink beer out of if you're starring
I
in Young Frankenstein.
It was glass.
All right, what's that?
What do you got over there? Looks like a Claymore mine. What is that? Oh, I think it's...
Poker chips?
Poker chips.
From a 1940s.
It's poker chips that Al Capone used.
You obviously,
you can't
yeah,
get the,
she obviously stopped at a garage
there
sale on the
looks
way
like
down to New York.
Poker chips in a hat box.
Oh, they're in a hat box.
Wow.
Wow.
I got some,
you got any cards with those chips? Oh, let's have a little hand
poker
just for fun.
Chips. I could sit here now and shuffle chips with one hand.
Mm, wow.
Like they do on the World Series of Poker.
That's just wonderful.
Oh,
this is good.
I'll bet there's a gift for Jim Norton in there.
This probably sat on top of a 60s style folding poker table for years.
I hate my gift.
What is that?
Dude, it's a joke because they were ranking on you. You had nothing.
What is,
what's that?
My gift stinks.
Oh, wow.
Oh, they're playing cards from the Moshesuck Valley Railroad Company. What the fuck is this?
Wow, I guess that guess there must be some more gifts in there.
No, that's it.
No?
What? Wait, you got a beer pitcher for Jim?
I just grabbed them for all of you to use.
But what about Jim?
But
Jim
I don't,
it's for everybody.
But that's not fair.
No, these are for everybody. It's not necessarily, I mean...
But I don't drink alcohol.
Exactly.
Could someone open the window?
Yeah, I'll take it back.
All right. Name of the game is Texas Hold'em, boys.
Ooh, we got chips and everything.
Yeah.
That would be great if they weren't... That that pack wasn't missing aces.
Huh, card with little cards.
Are there 52 in this?
I don't think there's 52 cards
oh, this
there.
Oh, should have
never brought these in at the donkey sausage.
At least the other pack of cards is still wrapped.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got one wrapped, one unwrapped.
Would you gamble at the bus station on the way here?
Yes, I did.
And then this pack, because there's four decks of cards, both of these are still wrapped.
Attaboy.
I'd love to know where these came from.
No idea.
Where'd you get them?
The store.
What store?
Her store.
Someone probably brought them
I can't
them
imagine
in.
Why the store is going under. Wait, I just can't fathom with...
With little tidbits like this?
Little trinkets and knickknacks?
Yeah, you might need better stuff in your store.
Maybe that's what it is.
Wow.
You were selling this?
There's plenty of stuff in there that was very nice.
I bet. That's
only
know
the best for your ooh pals, huh?
You God can throw it out the window.
Opie,
you
stop
can
looking around. I know him.
You just break it. I'd be happy if
I'm
you broke it.
I'm just trying to figure
no
out where
no
I could break it. This
no
place is so nice and
no
new. This,
no.
The state-of-the-art studio that we're
it's
in.
It's a bit. Opie
that
doesn't
the
really
that the
break
the gang from
things
XM Satellite built for us. And
Opie doesn't really break things. It's a joke.
I never broke a thing in my life.
It's a bit.
Oh, the cards have little trains on them.
Yeah, little choo-choos. Choo-choo!
Kind of well, if you haven't broken anything yet, you might as well, because it could be the, you know, the first thing you break in the studio. You broke your mouse, but that could be the second thing.
That's a good gift. You could have people over. You could put the dip in the one thing and the chips in the surrounding dish.
Martha Stewart. This is a very good suggestion.
All right, well, this is lovely. Thank you.
Nice I'm gift. Done. There's your couch.
All right.
Thank you for the couch and the gifts and everything. Oh,
you're
don't
You're welcome.
Why do you look so dejected?
Yeah.
I'm very happy. I play cards, and now I have chips
now you
and
have
choo-choo train
two,
cards.
Two packs of cards and a felt case.
Yeah, the case is felt with some gold leaf trim on the side.
That's right.
It's like an old velour shirt I had when I was 8.
Can I see those pictures?
I promise you're not going to break it.
Don't break anything, Opie.
No, I need the other one, too.
That's not bad.
Oh, I can't break this.
No, why would you?
It's glass.
It is glass, right?
Glass. People will...
They're both real glass?
Yeah, people will...
It's plastic.
I was ready to shout at that. No, I wasn't. I'm kidding.
No.
All right, Ben, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Enjoy.
We got the lesbian couch, which we will use tomorrow.
Opie got a nice gift, and Anthony got a nice gift, and... I don't drink, but I have beer pitchers that I can share
right,
with the
you
group.
Can put some
soda
pop
You don't
pop
work for the New York
it.
Times, do you?
You can put some soda pop in it.
Maybe I could have a Coke.
All right, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome, guys.
Okay.
Have a good one.
Thank you.
Well, we have to take our picture, don't we?
Well, I was gonna.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that.
Wait. No, don't.
It's, you're going to go right through that window. It's going to go through the...
What, Ben?
The control room window. No, Opie. Oh, my God, no. Opie, don't.
Don't do it. She's still there.
Oh, my God.
No.
It's, see, it. You put dip. You put dip in that.
Put dip
in
it.
And you put the chips in the
it's
around there.
It's not even washed out. It's nice.
And you can...
Look at the remnants from the dip.
From the last...
It was a going away party.
Great party, isn't it?
When you have your little party on Sunday for football.
Yeah.
Why is this place so nice? There's nothing to break it on.
Nah, you know, don't drop it on the floor.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
You just gave Jaime a heart attack.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Opie.
Oh, my God. You threw it.
Oh, my God. It's broken all over the place.
Yeah, you got the little... Now you just separated. You can put the dip in that dish.
All right, I'm not even looking out the window. I can't even look at her face now.
Why?
Because she gave you something and you fucking broke it.
I didn't think it would break that easily.
It's ceramic.
Yeah, it's rare when you throw ceramic on a hard floor that it breaks. I could see where you'd be confused.
Oh, my God. You are the worst human.
She's ready for her picture with you, Ope.
I can't even look outside.
No.
Why?
Oh, God. Not even smiling at all. I can't believe you. I cannot believe you.
You can fix that. A little glue.
Opie, look out the window. Look out the window.
She's going to cry.
No,
I'm sorry. Is she smiling?
Yeah, you can put this right back together. This is not even that much damage. You know?
All right, well. Oof. All right, well. Let's get out of this uncomfortable situation, please.
She's really hurt.
Opie, Anthony, Dance Party Weekend.
Wait, no.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
Comedy gone too far. And we're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Norton was just lying on the lesbian couch. It stinks, huh?
It's fine. It smells moldy. I'm just tired. I don't care.
All right. Well, aww. I like the lesbian couch. Thumbs up to the lesbian couch.
It'll smell like...
It has only one splooge stain, so that's good. That'll
Were
change
Were you trying
up.
To give her a thumbs
yeah,
up through
yeah,
the window?
That,
did
how
you notice
revolting
that?
Was that?
Thumbs up.
And she did...
I'm with you. She's just staring into space.
She's not even looking at you.
No.
She's not trying to make up for smashing her gift.
I just kind of tossed it to the side, and then it's shattered. I don't know.
It's ceramic, and you broke it on purpose, and
You're
you giggled.
You're an awful person.
All right, well.
And Ant's doing nothing but trashing those awful 1951 poker chips.
Yeah, see, that's the difference, though,
what?
Man.
What?
Why don't you say what you were saying during the commercial break, how much you hate your poker chips.
I said...
And wish you had balls like me.
That these days...
Those chips stink.
Nowadays, you can get chips that are the same chips you play with in Vegas.
You know
Atlantic
who uses
City
chips like that? Third graders.
Yeah, these
they need
chips
a little
are,
weight. They don't have any weight to
right,
them.
They need some weight. These are the plastic chips you used to play with like your junior high
They're
buddies.
Awful.
You'd steal them from your parents and play poker. They are awful plastic chips.
Give her the chips back.
Yeah, you
Why
got
should
it.
I give them back?
Just you don't tell, want her, them? Tell her you don't want them.
You might have to, but, Aunt. Oprah raised a good point.
Tell her you don't want her stupid chips.
Why do I have to be party to your rudeness?
Because you're like all brave when we're in commercial break.
But I can understand, you know, that,
you
that something might
gift.
Suck and I might hate it, but
and
I'm
Norton,
not going to...
What about you? These what? Gifts stink.
They do stink. I don't
want to be known as the bad guy today.
A hatbox full of chips.
The Lucille Ball hatbox she bought when she was out with Viv.
Dude, she got that from a garage
that little
sale.
Little stupid hat in the box.
Yeah,
now take it back, Lucy.
Now, Anthony.
That's what it looks like.
Call her back in here.
But I understand. I can get a bad gift and still be nice and not hurt people's
call
feelings.
Call her back in here and give her gift back.
Why do I have to hurt someone's feelings? I will not bow to peer pressure and
call
hurt someone's
her
feelings.
In. Call her out on her gift.
I will tell her her gift sucks, but I will keep
it. Oh, you will, huh?
Just give it back.
Yeah, let's see Anthony say that. You're really not coming back in here. Are you insane?
Erica. I just wanted to say, Opie had a little mishandling of your gift. He bobbled it a little while he was trying to put it over by his stuff, and it broke. But I have the cards and chips, and
you
thank
guys,
you.
You guys... I know. I know.
Tell her.
Throw what? Them out. You
tell
hate
her.
Them. I don't care.
What?
No. Don't bother me.
What? Are those good chips? I'm not saying that they're bad chips. Are they good
no,
chips?
They're old. They're probably from the 70s. I just grabbed them.
70s Earth Mama chips.
70s Earth Mama Muff chips.
It would have been cool
away,
if it came from
them.
Frank Sinatra's house, but obviously it didn't.
You know, they could be worth money. You don't know.
Well, if they were worth money, you'd be getting married.
You know,
what's wrong with that? Nice. That's a genuine wood chip holder, isn't it?
Hey, give me those chips.
Look for my face, Steve.
No, look.
Give
Opie the chips.
Look,
Opie
I'm just thinking. I like them. I really do. But I'm thinking maybe somebody else could use them more than I could.
I'd be more than happy to take them and throw them in the trash for you,
no,
Anthony.
No, I'm not going
to
throw them in the trash,
Anthony,
but perhaps somebody could use them more.
Than
I'll take them back, Anthony. Just give them to me.
Tell her.
She's yelling.
Tell her.
I'm trying to be nice.
What do you mean someone...
Why
that,
am I being yelled
You play
at?
Texas Hold'em. Why can't you use those?
Well, they're just not... quite the type of equipment I like playing with.
What kind do you
That's
like playing
all.
With? They're it's chips and cards.
Well, different cards and different chips. People yeah. play with different types of things. Yes, sir?
I'll pass it back to
Just give her the chips.
Just, Opie, give those to her. And
it's heavy.
Yeah, these are the cards that are still...
There you go. They're all wrapped up.
See? They're still wrapped.
They're all wrapped up.
You ever play 52 card pickup?
Oh,
Opie. There's no reason to heave the cards at her.
Did the cards hit you? Did they?
Oh, but she got cards falling off her sleeve.
Come on. No. Oh, God damn it. Oh, my God. Oh, God. Holy shit. Oh, B.
Don't videotape.
Oh, boy.
Now clean it up!
Are you happy now, Opie? Are you happy?
I am mortified.
Oh, Eric called. She
I'm
spilled
not mortified.
My chips.
I knew you'd do stuff like this. Thanks.
She spilled my chips. Oh, God. You guinea brat, now clean it up!
That's right, be a poker player, just like your father!
Oh my God, I'm mortified. I apologize for the other half of this program. Because
don't
that
apologize,
is,
I don't really care.
That is uncalled for. That was uncalled for.
I hope you got a good laugh. I hope you got a good laugh.
Got. He's still immersed in it.
It's fine. He can laugh.
I can't even talk.
I knew from the start it was a bad idea to bring those in the first place. I should have just brought the couch and be done with it.
That is horrible. Look, I didn't have a problem with them or anything. For some reason, I don't understand why he's got to be like that.
Oh, my God, it hurts.
I apologize for the actions of some of the people on this program, you know.
Well, enjoy picking up your poker chips.
Thank you.
You guys can finish your show and talk about me and do whatever you want. I don't care.
All right. There she goes.
Bye, guys.
Wait.
She's walking away.
Wait, can you take these?
Oh, look, she's getting her stuff. She's not even going to sit back down now. She's getting her stuff and walk. Oh, my God. There she goes.
Ben, go smooth things over.
Ben, smooth things over a little bit.
Remember when Rick had to smooth things over?
Yeah,
guess what?
Now it's your fucking job.
If you wanted to be the big dog, go ahead. There it is.
Yeah, you're the big producer now. Go fix that.
That is the biggest laugh I've had on the show.
We broke it. You fix it.
Because the way you threw them and rolled them across the console, it was a heavy thud and they rolled and all just fell
off. And the chips are flying out and the chip carrier fell on her foot. It's just... It was the most horrible thing I've ever seen one person do to another.
That's the biggest laugh I've had on the show.
I couldn't breathe.
You are an awful person.
I literally could not breathe. I was laughing so hard.
I don't know how you do that.
That just makes me so happy.
Those are things you think about doing sometimes, but no human does them. But Opie, just hey,
oh, these
I'll chips. I'll break your bowl. I'll throw the chips at you. I'll fling the cards at your face.
Oh, these chips have coffee stains on them. These are awful.
Oh, see, now you're brave.
Oh, I can't be brave with you.
Holy S, the back of my skull hurts. I laugh so hard.
Eric from Jersey, the sound of plastic chips raining to the floor is the saddest sound I've ever heard. It will be like the sound of the thousands of tears she's going to shed in the car.
Yo,
yeah.
Just walk outside with Ben. Ben's talking to her right now.
Yeah.
Gave her a nice garbage bag full of O&A stuff. She is bawling, crying.
Oh, my God. See? I knew it.
Here's what she said. She goes, I don't mind if he broke it, but he threw it at me.
Oh, no.
And she turned her face into the wall near the elevator and just...
Oh, my God.
That's all
God,
you're hearing.
Stop it. You are horrible.
Cringe Radio is back, boys and girls. It's about effing time.
She threw the chips.
I didn't throw them at her. Hold on a
minute. Things being smoothed over.
He actually
them.
Didn't throw them at
I'm
her.
I'm going to go check now, but
she I was a very good athlete when I was growing up, and trust me, I didn't throw them at
go
her.
Go fix that.
I made it very close, but
go fix that. Oh, my God. Oh, that's awful. I cannot believe that. I'm horrified.
All right.
Opie has no soul, evil to the core.
Yeah.
That's what they're writing.
And I wonder why I'm alone.
Opie is the effing Antichrist.
And I wonder why I'm alone. I go home alone every day and I wonder why.
Why am I alone?
Right, Jesus. Can't figure that one out.
You made her cry.
I didn't want her to cry.
She was nice, and she tried to be good-natured about it.
I know. She tried to take the ribbing.
It was the loud loud chips falling before the thing rolled off the console.
That was a big bet. I'm all in. I will splash the pot whenever the fuck
dude,
I please.
Dude, you gotta read some of the instant feedback. This guy, Cody from Buffalo. Opie put some good force into throwing those chips. Sounds like some South American ring stick.
No, that's,
All right, well.
I was horrified during that whole thing. An update?
Yeah.
Yeah, Ben's calming her down. Steve's out there. They're, you know, getting her to breathe and calm down. And they're going to try to see if she wants to come back in and get her picture.
Yeah, because she wanted pictures and stuff.
Tell her if she cleans up.
See, you're brave without her in the studio. That's the difference.
I admit it.
That's the difference between you and I. You say that to her face. I've done enough.
Haven't you done enough?
I think I've done enough.
I can't.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Ben,
even...
what's going on out there?
It's just it's not fun, Ope. You threw it right at her.
I didn't throw it right at her. Do we have the videotape? You didn't get that on videotape?
Yeah, I did.
You got that on videotape?
It kind of rolled on the console.
I kind of just rolled it at her.
Okay. Well,
she had plenty of time to get out of the way.
Oh, geez.
She's a little upset.
Yeah, I would guess.
Drove all the way here from Rhode Island.
Just to give something to the show?
Yeah. Want to get her photo.
Oh, my God. She comes here to give something to the show and get a picture with Opie and Anthony.
Well, maybe she should have gave something to us from this decade.
What are you, who are you to say that our gifts aren't good enough?
You know what?
For now on, we don't want...
Frankincense and myrrh not a good enough gift, Opie?
We're starting a rule on the show. You bring gifts, don't get them from a garage sale. That's all we ask.
You know, baby Jesus' best gift he got was a song from a little drummer boy.
That's right.
Opie. It had nothing to do with materialism, had nothing to do with the gold, frankincense, and myrrh might have been good gifts, but the little drummer boy's song was the best gift of all. And I'd have taken that over those lousy chips.
All right, well, let me see the video, Anthony.
All right, here's the video. We're looking right back at the tape.
She's all smiley.
Steve, I'll need a screening when you're done there.
Oh, my God. Well, you kind of missed the toss, but you got the aftermath.
I wasn't really expecting you to do that, to be honest.
Oh, gee.
What did you think he was going to do, play a hand?
It's like catching a UFO. You're just not expecting it.
Wow, that's... Well, look at Norton. This is going to be great for FoundryMusic.com.
I'm all in.
Show Anthony.
All right, bring that over here. Right. I got to see that.
I think the audio will really help that clip. Because you were too close on her face, but all you see is the chips go flying by her. All right, well.
All right, let me get a look. All right, there's Opie with the devious smile on his face. She's talking, still yes, smiling. Oh, my God, no, that's...
Oh, you see it clearly.
That is...
You just see the chips flying by on the table.
Yes, Ben.
Not as if we've done enough damage to being in this new building already.
Yeah.
There's people just coming to work, getting off the elevator,
yeah,
and see this all going on in the hallway,
oh,
and are
no,
just mortified.
Oh, they see her crying out front,
oh,
him filming it.
No. See that? Yeah.
Not even trying to comfort her. Could you face this way when you break down emotionally?
Oh, I'm horrified. I am horrified.
Yeah, I'm not going to fix this one.
See, this is the type of thing, the barrier that people say, you know, how far do you take things on satellite radio? That's where, you know, I think the line should have been drawn somewhere.
Yeah.
Girl just trying to bring some gifts to the show.
I definitely...
Give me those, I'll pass them.
She enjoyed...
What?
Give me those, I'll pass them to her. You're horrible, man.
That clip is hilarious. You see her face, and then in the background, you see the chips just flying by on the table.
Look at the construction workers looking in like, what the hell's going on in there?
All right, well.
Awful.
Should we take our last break and then regroup here, I guess?
I think, yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, that was great.
Why
don't you go out and take your picture with her, Ope?
Yeah.
Old fan from the AAF days.
She's been a fan since the AAF days.
Whatever.
First time in 10 years she's going to meet us.
Go buy Demented World and shut up. No, she's a nice lady.
Oh,
I'm just waiting for them to hit the commercial because I'm really uncomfortable still. Go.
Coming up next on Opie and Anthony, Jim Norton sings.
Forget me not, you sightless taunt. Your dog just shit on my rug.
Thought that was pretty fucking funny, didn't you?
How's that for a sketch?
The Opie and Anthony Show.
You don't do sketches, stupid.
It's the O&A virus.